In today's video, we will be taking a look at new variable neutral density filters by Freewell. Variable ND filter is definitely a very useful piece of accessory mainly for filmmaking. As you probably know, it allows you to lower your shutter speed to help you follow 180 degree shutter rule and achieve the right amount of motion blur for your cinematic look. In this video, we will take a look at these 2-5 and 6-9 stop VNDs at their optical qualities and overall usability. I've been testing these with Sony a7 III, Tamron 28-75mm f2.8DI3RXD, and Sony FE24mm f1.4GM. You can buy these filters separately, or as you can see here, you can buy both filters as all day package. In the box, you will get ND225 and ND629, case for each filter, magnetic lens cap, magnetic ring, cleaning cloth, and documentation. This is 67mm version, which fits my 28-75 and 24mm GM, as well as 17-28 Tamron that I will be getting soon. Also available are 72, 77 and 82mm versions. For smaller diameters, you can use step-up rings. The build quality of these filters is excellent. The whole construction is metal and they feel very solid. The thickness of these filters is just 7.7mm. The diameter of these filters is a bit larger, these are about 75mm because there has to be some space for the turning mechanism. I also like the amount of resistance when turning the rotatable part of the filter. There are hard stops on both filters, so we won't get that X pattern like on some other variable filters. These filters have usual threads, so you can just mount them onto your lens like any other filters. I also like the magnetic lens cap a lot. It is very practical and convenient to use, it takes less space and the attachment is very secure. I use this lens cap on both 28-75 and 24mm GM just with UV filters. Two cases are also included with filters, these have magnetic latches and they work well. The only thing that I don't like about these is that you can't close them with lens cap attached. So how about the optical qualities? You may have already seen some sample clips shot with these filters in my previous videos. For example, all of the sample footage in Zion We Build S review was shot using these filters. I have also taken a couple of stills with Sony a7 III, Tamron 28-75mm f2.8 and these filters attached to see whether there is noticeable difference in image quality. And to my own surprise, on 24 megapixel sensor with very sharp 28-75, I wasn't able to see any decrease in sharpness. I have tried both filters from lowest to highest density and I couldn't tell the difference. There is a tiny bit of chromatic aberration on 6-9 stop filter, but that is only visible at 400% magnification in 6K stills. For all intended purposes, I can say that these filters will not decrease the sharpness or contrast of your 4K or 6K videos. You can see the results yourself and it seems like this is very good glass. 2-5 stop filter is probably the one that you will use more often. This one is suitable for everything from sunsets to relatively bright midday shooting at ISO 100. 6-9 stop ND filter is suitable for bright summer days and also for shooting lock. With most cameras, you need to use higher ISO for lock shooting. On Sony S-Log it is ISO 800 for example. In those situations, you usually need to use ND filters, especially if you want to use wide aperture, and for those situations, you will need more than 5 stops of ND. Freewell also makes other filters as I have shown you in previous videos. They have a very useful magnetic attachment system. These variable filters don't use this system because you won't be changing them so often, but magnetic adapter is included in the box. You can mount your variable ND filters on other filters, like for example circular polarizer, and use them together. To be honest, this was the first time that I have used variable ND filters. Before, I was using aperture priority or I would just crank up the shutter speed. I was kind of wondering why should I use these, but during my testing I realized that the right question is why not. Managing the exposure with these ND filters was actually easier and faster than figuring out the manual settings. It will also prevent exposure changes in the middle of the shot, which is a problem with aperture priority, and I will get the right amount of cinematic motion blur as a bonus. The price is also really good, especially considering the optical qualities. And I know that buying filter is not as exciting as buying a new lens or a camera, for example, but this will last you many years, so it is a good investment. Overall, I am very happy with these filters. I like the build quality, optical qualities, and the handling. 2 to 9 stops is sufficient ND range, and the price is very reasonable. The only minor complaints that I have are that only one magnetic cap is included for two filters, and that the case can't be closed with attached lens cap, but those are really minor complaints, so I highly recommend these filters. So that's it for this video, thank you for watching, I hope that you liked this video and that you have found it to be useful. Stay tuned for more videos and maybe consider subscribing if you don't want to miss my future content. I appreciate your feedback in form of thumbs up or thumbs down. If you would like to ask anything or share your opinion, please do so in the comment section, and see you next time.